Sorry, my apologies for delay. There was some glitch, and I'm really sorry for that. Welcome to all the esteemed guests, Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, the most efficient, dynamic, and responsive Chief Minister we ever had. I'm very happy that he has spared his time to come and spend some time with us. ASSOCHAM has always been at the forefront of attracting investments, and Atmanirbhar Bharat, which is a call given by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, which also will make India self-reliant and help propel India to greater heights and reach $5 trillion US economy. And that is what every state, and Goa is not lagging behind. They are also taking enough measures in this direction. So may I request our Honorable President to welcome this August gathering. Dr. Niranjan?
Yeah. Honorable Chief Minister, Dr. Pramod Sawant, it is such a pleasure to be with you again. This is the third time in 1 year that I have had the good fortune to meet you up, sir. If you remember, we were there on 17th of December during Growth Agenda in Goa, when we had the first occasion that I could interact with you, sir, and I could see the same positivism that is there in your mind, heart, and execution of the work that you have been doing. It's such a pleasure to have you here today, sir. Thank you very much for joining ASSOCHAM's journey, so to say, in the direction in which the Honorable Prime Minister is taken up, whether it is the $5 trillion economy, the growth agenda which is there, the Atmanirbhar Bharat, the attractiveness to bring about investments into India, to bring about various sectors of the economy and to take it forward. It's my pleasure also to have Mr. Vineet Agarwal, my Senior Vice President, Mr. Ashok Kumar, Mr. Riker, Mr. Koilo, Mr. Parimal, all of you, most welcome, and all the other listeners who are panelists here today. ASSOCHAM is very happy. Happy because we are spending 100 years of service to the nation. The work which has been done by ASSOCHAM, sir, I must tell you, we have with us directly and indirectly through our various associations, 4,50,000 members who are in the MSME sector. So they are the ones who actually pick up a large portion of the employment in the country, whether it is in your state or the rest of the country. They are a very, very important and focused segment. And that is why our association has different agendas in terms of importance given to MSME sector. Sir, I must congratulate you again. You have had a very challenging time in Goa. The mining sector, which has been grossly affected, has hit almost 30% of the economy of the country in Goa. And also the fact that COVID also hit the entire nation, which brought us to a full stop. But I must proudly tell you and happily tell you that I have so many friends and relatives who, even in this COVID period, just want to go to Goa. Now, this I can't understand why, because there is such a dangerous position, but somehow or the other, you have been able to manage that leadership in order to project a correct thought of thought and vision and direction, which is extremely important and indicates the kind of leadership there is there. I do a lot of my real estate in Mumbai, and I'm asking many people who come from Delhi, why don't you buy a property in Mumbai? They said, no. Are you constructing in Goa? I'm willing to come over there. So there is some magnetism about Goa, which you must explain to us and tell us what your secret is. We are also very proud of the fact that in the direction of what the Prime Minister has said about Atmanirbhar Bharat, you have also been doing that. My friends are there in industry. They are in the pharmaceutical industry. They are in the ancillary industry of various products. And they also have their factories in Goa. There is some magnetism about what you have done and the leadership role that we see as far as the industrialization of Goa to come. You are the smallest state in the country, but you have the highest per capita income. It is well connected. by road, rail, and all the other sea routes. You have a magnetism which draws people and visitors, not only from the rest of India for tourism, but the entire world coming to you in terms of tourism activity. There is something special about it. You have also concentrated, sir, on industrial activities. And there are various 20 industrial estates which have come up in Goa. You have also 50 subsectors, which include tourism, pharmaceuticals, electricals, and automobile auxiliaries. All these things are extremely important to understand. The banks also tell us that the deposits to credit ratio is very high, which means that the people in Goa are relatively rich and borrow less money than the rest of the country. This is a different character which banks are telling us and give us information. And it is quite interesting for us to learn this knowledge. You have also saw a lot of potential. Potential in the knowledge industry. We do believe, sir, that you can concentrate and get and attract, which you have the resources to do, more software development, additional pharmaceutical industry. You know how vaccine has become so important. Technology, engineering services, and all these activities can be further focused in. ASSOCHAM, sir, will be fully supportive with you in order to see all these industrialization takes place at an accelerated level in line with what the direction is. If we have to reach the $5 trillion economy, each and every state, each and every place has to play its important role. I do believe, sir, that whatever you are doing is in the right direction. Please tell us what we can do for you in order to accelerate that. China has got a labor cost which is very high. Large number of factories are leaving China. However, many of them are going to Vietnam, they're going to Bangladesh and other countries. We have been making a study of these positions, and we do find there are certain issues that we need to address, not in Goa alone, but the rest of the country too. The ease of doing business needs to be focused. The cost of electricity needs to be considered, because that is much cheaper in places like Bangladesh and Pakistan. And that becomes an important factor in order to see that this industrialization can be done. We need to be competitive. We need to see that our transport, communication, road, railway, and other network needs to be encouraged and improved. Private participation is most welcome. And sir, we are very, very proud of you. A young chief minister who is leading such a wonderful state. God bless you. I wish you all the very, very best for the lot of progress for Goa. You have a special relationship in all that. My children and grandchildren also want to come to Goa every year. So we have a separate fondness for them. So even if I am hesitant and saying, all right, next time jayenge, my grandchildren says, chalo, Goa chalte hain. So I think, sir, you have some natural magnetism about you and your state. So please enlighten us and tell us how this magnetism works. Maybe you can even give us guidance where ASSOCHAM can be shoulder to shoulder with you in the progress of Goa and the progress of the nation as led by Dr. Pramod Sawant and also our Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi. All the very, very best to you. And I wish you all the very best this year. And of course, after the vaccine, we hope that we will meet up again personally to take this forward to the next level. Thank you very much, sir.
In 2 days' time, we will be celebrating the 60th Liberation Day in Goa. With a robust infrastructure in place and more to come, Goa is marching ahead as per the guidelines of our Honorable Prime Minister. And our Chief Minister is really a go-getter who will get things done with his firm hands. May I now request all my panelists to take on the stage, but for a limited time only, as we have a very short time. May I start with Sri Vineet Agarwal ji.
Thank you, Mr. Raikar, and it's my pleasure to welcome Honorable Chief Minister Dr. Pramod Sawant today. Sir, I'm not going to repeat whatever Mr. Niranjan Nandani, Dr. Nandani has just said, but I must certainly commend one or two things that the organized that your state has done from an e-government initiative, which are absolutely commendable and very unique. You have created the state data center, the Goa broadband network. I think these are just fantastic initiatives. I have a proposal, sir, which I was thinking about. Can Goa become the first smart state of the country? I think there's a lot of talk about smart cities, but I think if you can change the paradigm and make Goa the first smart state of the country, I think this will be absolutely one of the unique propositions that can be created. And the way to do that, you've already identified 50 sectors, but there could be some innovation districts that you could make in certain areas of the state, which could act as a hub to attract people who are already coming. Like Ms. Dr. Hindani just said, there are already people who are attracted with the magnetism of Goa. If we can bring those knowledge workers more and more towards these innovation districts, I think they will create this necessary infrastructure, the mindset and the ecosystem to be to create a smart state. And of course, you'll need to do a lot of other things, build the right transport infrastructure, the right framework for governance, which will ensure that you become the first smart state of the country. So, sir, this was just a recommendation, and we at ASSOCHAM can work with you to come out with reports on how this can be achieved and closely ensure that we take we work with your government to create certain frameworks around this. So this was a suggestion that I had, sir. And we again thank you on behalf of ASSOCHAM to join us here today. Thank you, sir.
Sir, I must.
Thank you, Vinit.
I'd like to mention that Mr. Vinit Agarwal is the president-elect and succeeds me in ASSOCHAM as the next president, and is in the logistics space and does a lot of work in the logistics space in this country and has been a leader in that direction and can give us good guidance and direction into the logistics and other aspects of how we can take that difference and connectivity that could be done. I'm sorry I did not introduce him before.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. So, rightly said, Vinit ji, and Goa being, very sensitive to ecology, what you said really makes sense. And I think we can take this forward with the help of the Chief Minister. May I now request Shri Jayant Parimal ji, CEO of Adani Green Energy, to have his say.
Good evening, sir. Honorable Chief Minister, sir. First of all, let me congratulate you and thank you for having agreed to come to this event. Sir, I belong to renewable sector, so I have some selfish things which I would like to mention to you. You have already taken a lot of progressive steps as far as promotion of renewable energy is concerned. India, under Honorable Prime Minister, has already taken up a lot of targets which are Paris Agreement Plus. I would recommend that Goa, being one of the most progressive state, should look at something which is India Plus. Right now, decarbonization is one of the most important theme. You have already taken a lot of steps on greening the grid. I would also recommend that you should look at greening the mobility in a big way and greening the chemicals, which will go a big way in improving the ecology and atmosphere, not only in Goa, but also you will become the front runner. We can help you to plan something like, all your vehicles, etc., they move on either biofuel or electric fuel or something similar to that. And maybe we can try to compete or outcompete the European Union, who are trying to reach a particular level by 2030. You being a progressive state and you being a progressive chief minister, sir, and with a manageable physical area, you can easily do some of these things like decarbonizing the mobility, either through electric vehicle or biofuel or electric fuel. In fact, that is nothing but green hydrogen and green hydrogen to methanol or something of that kind, so that we take out the pollutants, take out the greenhouse gases. We have taken up the Prime Minister has taken up that journey of 5 trillion economy, And I am sure we cannot achieve the 5 trillion economy without a very vibrant decarbonization stuff. He has already given a lot of stuff at Government of India level, but I would urge you to take something India plus, and at ASSOCHAM, we can definitely help you to shout out them. Decarbonization is not so expensive, sir. If you take the whole thing, you know, carbon tax, et cetera, in mind, decarbonization is not so expensive. And you can become a model state. In any case, you are the king of, tourism in India. And a decarbonized state of Goa will be even an added attraction to all the people who are flocking to Goa. So this is my recommendation, sir. And we will be very happy to help you to chart out a program, 5-year, 10-year program, so that by 2030, majority of the mobility or the electricity can be decarbonized, sir. So I take this opportunity to thank you again on behalf of ASSOCHAM, and we'll be happy to help you in any ways. Thank you.
Mr. Parimal ji, and may I now invite Sri Joseph Coelho, Chief Operating Officer and the Interim Director of Vedanta Seza Goa. Please go ahead, sir.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor for me to address this August gathering on behalf of Vedanta Limited, Seza Goa, INO. I would first like to congratulate ASSOCHAM for organizing this government industry interaction for an Atmanirbhar Bharat roadmap towards a $5 trillion US dollar economy. We have amongst us Dr. Pramod Sawant, Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Government of Goa. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate on the wonderful performance in the recently concluded Jilla Parishad election, which has been a testament to his leadership in these difficult times. The economic crisis precipitated by the COVID-19 pandemic has resulted in reforms being brought in by the Union government, which I am certain will turn our great nation on the path of high economic growth and creation of gainful employment opportunities. It is estimated that over the next 10 years, approximately 10 crore new jobs will be created to absorb new entrants in the job markets. The estimates are based upon the current demographics. To meet this lofty job creation targets, our country needs to grow at least at 9% annually over the next 10 years. As such, the reforms brought out by the Union government under the Atmanirbhar Bharat package will go a long way in meeting the growth needs to the country. We at Vedanta Seza Goa INO are committed to the vision of Atmanirbhar Bharat as laid down by our chairman, Sri Anil Agarwal. Focusing on the theme of the present interaction in a federative structure of governance like that in India, the states play a key role in driving the growth agenda of the nation. While the current call of the Atmanirbhar Bharat has been given by the Honorable Prime Minister, it is up to the respective state governments to implement the reforms at micro level and ensure the benefits of the reforms are actually seen on the ground. The states need to be positive, flexible, and farsighted while pushing such developmental agenda. We have amongst us the dynamic Chief Minister of Goa, Dr. Pramod Sawant, whose leadership has set a barometer in driving the growth agenda of the nation and the state for others to follow. It is he who, to complement the broader objective of Atmanirbhar Bharat, has given a mantra of Swampurna Goa, which envisages a self-reliant and prosperous Goa. I would like to share a small anecdote about his progressive approach. While mining activities had stopped in the state from March 2018 onwards, Dr. Sawant's innovative approach to allow beneficiation of auction ore by the state government, which not only led to job protection of around 1,500 employees, but also provided livelihood opportunities to thousands of truckers, barge workers, amongst others, which helped to alleviate the financial distress during these tough times. I'm certain that under his able leadership, the mining industry shall soon be up and running, contributing to the nation building in the near future. During the inaugural session of this forum, as also our chairman, Sri Anil Agarwal, has stressed that restarting of the stall mines would help India achieve its aim of being a $5 trillion economy. I will share some ideas which could potentially help the state of Goa to be on the path of growth. First is, the state can look at setting up of an automotive potential growth over the next 5 years. As per conservative estimates, the automotive die casting industry is expected to grow annually at a CAGR of 6.9% over the next few years. Goa, being home to the biggest merchant peak iron manufacturing capacity in the country, is in a unique position to tap this industry, which is largely labor intensive and can help bring global car manufacturers, both traditional and new age electric, to the state's doorsteps. The second one is, with the state being blessed with a long coastline, I believe the state can also focus upon encouraging setting up of modern shipyards which cater to an increasing customized demand of marine vessels for short-haul commercial use. The state can incentivize local shipyards for adoption of modern shipbuilding technologies such as use of bunker paper, which is actually a thin sheet of carbon tubes for shipbuilding, use of integrated propulsion system, robotics adoption, developing of solar, wind, powered ships, etc. Sir, we require another, actually, Goa Shipyard Limited in Goa. Third point is, Goa also always had a great number of qualified professionals and graduates such as engineers, lawyers, chartered accountants, etc. I believe that we should utilize this strength and develop knowledge sharing, knowledge process outsourcing hub in the state. With big corporations in the West increasingly looking to contract our knowledge, out knowledge-based work to organizations in the country, the global KPO market size was evaluated at US $28.94 in 2016, is anticipated to reach $125 billion by 2025, with India garnering 70% of the global market. The government should also look forward to bringing administrative reforms which will look forward to bringing commercial reforms which will recognize and incentivize government officials who are exceptional performers in public life. The state should also set up a time-bound delivery system for clearing industry-related issues and files. The transparent-bound system shall further attract private sector to invest in the state. As the state approaches its 60th Liberation Day, I would like to visit... I wish you all...
A memorandum to the Honorable Chief Minister regarding all these proposals.
Yes. Okay. Sure. I'll do that.
With you, sir. I'll do that. Because of the paucity of the time.
Yes. Sir,
finish. We have lined up a number of who have joined us today. They are all eagerly waiting to hear from you. And all the investors actually, you know, were asking me about Goa, and I told them that Goa is one place which has a stable government, which everybody looks forward. People have reiterated their faith in you, sir, which can be seen from the results of Jilla Parishad last time, which you have swept in Goa. Congratulations to you, sir, for this. But at the same time, we also look for your guidance, because, you know, all these investors who come here, they will be investing. We also, employment will be generated, and we look forward for your guidance and assistance in this matter. Honorable Chief Minister of Goa, Dr. Pramod Sawant. Sir.
For the Foundation Week 2020 State Driving India Growth Agenda, for this program, along with me, Dr. Niranjan Hiranandani ji, Sri Vinit Agrawal ji, Sri Mangirish Pai Raikar, Sri Joseph, Sri Sumant and other dignitaries present. First of all, thank you for Dr. Niranjan Hiranandani ji for the speaking so well about the Goa and about me. I am delighted to be the part of the celebration of 100 years of ASSOCHAM, the Associate Chamber of the Commerce and Industry. This is the oldest and largest apex chamber of the commerce, which has been representing the interest of industry and trade organization to the help in the economic growth of India. The chamber has dedicated itself to key areas like promoting India as an investment destination, achieving the international competitiveness, and promoting the international trade. Goa could play an important role in achieving these objectives. My hearty congratulations and best wishes to ASSOCHAM on achieving the milestone of the century of the services. The state of Goa has witnessed the considerable amount of growth in the last few years. Our infrastructure development has been going on the very fast pace, and investors are looking to Goa as a profitable investment destination. The gross state domestic product of the Goa at current price is increased at a compound annual growth rate is 10.88% between 2015-16 and 2019-21. The Goa's net state domestic product was rupees 66,000 crores in 2018-19. In past, the Goa's economic growth has been given by the strong performance of the sectors such as mining, tourism and pharmaceuticals. However, this year it has been a challenging for us due to the COVID-19 pandemic and also no mining activity. However, we have not stopped our pursuit of growth and development for the people of Goa. As of the August 2020, Goa has a total installed the power generation capacity of 584.83 megawatt. Goa is one of the few states in India is achieving the 100% rural electrification. Goa is a well-developed social, physical and industrial infrastructure and mobile and internet connectivity. We have an international airport and significant seaport rail infrastructure. The state has established the base for the pharmaceutical industry, and we are in emerging destination for the knowledge-based industries such as IT, startup, film shootings, etc. Goa is proud to be the permanent venue for the International Film Festival of India and 2020 edition, and which could not be held in the November and will be now held in the January 2021. The second Greenfield International Airport is being developed in Mopa, Goa, with the annual capacity of handle 30 million passengers when it is fully operational. The new export policy for the state is also being prepared to promote the export for the manufacturing goods and surplus agricultural produce. The state is in process of developing the logistics sector in Goa by forming the special logistic group. We are in constructing the several bridges to address the existing deficiencies regarding the logistic and warehouses. In 2019, the Goa witnessed the arrival of the 70 lakh plus domestic tourists and 9 lakh foreign tourists. In 2020, the number would be the lower side due to the pandemic. The government of Goa has prepared the roadmap for the future of Goa. Our aim is to develop the Goa as a skill intensive hub of economic activity where the system of production are enhanced with the ecological protections to ensure the quality of the life that is sustainable. The industries like tourism, mining and pharmaceuticals have been a great success and for the state in the past and going forward. It is important to focus on the other sectors. However, of late there has been the substantial challenges of availability of the land for the industrial expansion. As a part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat Swayampurna Goa, the project that I have launched in the state, the benefits of all the states and the central government scheme will be taken to the doorstep of the people. Our government officers are on the job every weekend by visiting the panchayat to ensure that we make the every efforts to tap our resources to help us and becoming the self-reliant, and the response has been overwhelming. This year, the 19th December onwards, the Goa is stepping into the 60th year of the liberation from the Portuguese. The state government has planned the variety of the program with the objective of showcasing and diverse culture and to promote the tourism. We intend to promote the interland tourism and medical tourism the sports tourism in the big way. For this function on the 19th December, our Honorable Rashtrapati Ramnath Kovind ji is coming for the inaugural of this function on the 19th of December for the evening for the inaugural function. Our IT policy offers the many incentives, and while our startup policy aims to be an opportunity to young entrepreneurs and innovative business in order to make Goa as the preferred startup destination of India. The infrastructure project taken up by my government is definitely going to make the Goa more attractive for the investors as well as for the tourists. The government of Goa is taking the many steps to boost the ease of doing the business in Goa. And AMRI Investment Promotion Act will be the soon be passed in the Goa to facilitate the investment in key focus sectors like IT, education, films, entertainment, tourism, etc. To facilitate the tourism industry, the extension of the license and amendment in the excise law to make it more simpler and to remove some provisions like the requirement of the police clearance every year has been removed. The COVID-19 pandemic has affected our lives badly this year. It has affected our business badly, and so many people have lost job and are struggling to bring their lives back on track. The government has huge challenges to face in the bringing about the normalcy. While all the efforts are being made to tackle the pandemic and reduce the number of casualties, the news about the vaccines has been much awaited. We have survived the worst, and now it's time to work to achieve our best. The government of Goa is prepared to face the challenges and geared up to get up our economy on the fast track. While the pharmaceutical industries has been efficiently handling their responsibilities, the tourism sector is also picking up. The investment will be the fast track, and infrastructure development will continue showing the progress. We look forward to working with the industry and business association in Goa as well as with the ASSOCHAM to grow the economy of Goa. I wish ASSOCHAM with all the best and invite you to be part of our success story in Goa. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Pramodji. Thank you so much for being with us. We promise you that we will be there to help you and take this state marching forward. Sir, we would like to be part of improvement in the logistics also, because we have given a suggestion and a proportional project regarding logistics to the government. We would be very happy to come and give a presentation in that regards. Secondly, sir, there are a lot of investors now who have been tagged for your speech. They are eagerly waiting to make an entry. We would also like to come with them and pay a visit to you, so that they could get your blessings before they start their entry and operations in Goa. Thank you so much for being with us and giving us a very promising start. We wish you all the very best for the Liberation Day celebration, and I'm sure that the next year will bring us more happiness and better times in the event. One thing which I would like to make a mention before I leave is that, sir, thank you very much for your help. And because of it, the total manufacturing of the country, 10% of it is manufactured in Goa in pharma sector. This is only because you helped them in the times of crisis. Thank you so much. We are indebted to you. Thank you all the faculty members who joined us, Dr. Nilanjan Hiranandani, our incoming president, Vinit Ji, Agarwal, Parimal Ji, Coelho Ji. All of you had made this a very lively session. Thank you so much. Thank you one and all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.